Hi, my name is Michael Barton. I'm a data scientist with a background in software engineering, and I built a system to recommend video games that you would like to play. I built this system using data from the Steam platform, which has millions of users and millions of games. So why would we recommend games if we're on Steam? Well, there's lots of research to show that narrowing down the choices that somebody has is more likely to lead to sales or conversion. And as you know, it works. There's plenty of examples like Netflix, Amazon, who use recommenders for a lot of their business. So the specific problem I was trying to solve with my recommender was how many games does a user need to play before being included in my model, and how many plays does a game need before being included in the model? And so why are we asking these questions? Well, consider this. We have a user who's played one game. Is it going to be valuable to recommend them anything? Probably not, because we don't really know enough about them. Or at the same time, this user has played one game, should we include them in the training of our model? Well, are they really going to add anything to the community to get recommendations that might be similar to them? Also no. So that's why I'm trying to answer this problem. So the first thing I had to decide was what value to train on, and what I'm looking at is how much time a user has spent playing a game. This is implicit data instead of an explicit rating, because Steam just does not have a lot of explicit ratings for the games. I built this model using Spark, and that's because Spark is able to do parallel computation across many machines, so it can solve this problem very quickly. Now, there's a lot of standard data science metrics that actually cannot be used in the evaluation of a recommender system. So one of the main problems is how to evaluate this model that we build. If we use a standard metric, which seems to be improving, what we're actually just improving is how well we can predict your score for something or how long you'll play it. But what we really want to do is predict what games to show you, what would be the best order to show you a rank of games. So Spark, unfortunately, does not have this metric, so I had to actually code this up in Spark by myself. But what we're looking at is to find the game for each ranking that we give to each user. And that game is something more is better. There's some blockers, though, with this, some things that pop up where you think you're doing better. Like, for example, if I keep on saying, okay, for this game, I'm going to only pick games that have one or more users, two or more users, three or more users, it would look like you're improving your model, but it's only because, if you think about it, at the end, if I only have one game, I'm always going to have a perfect recommendation. I'll recommend you the one game. So what we really want to look at is, what is our model doing compared to a random model? This is the solution I came up with to solve this problem. So you can see that, for example, if I have a user who's played one or more games and I build my model completely based on that, they'll have a certain percentage increase over random. If I only include users who have played two or more games, three or more games, the model starts to improve. Unfortunately, as we choose users who played five or more games, six or more games, you can see that the number of users we're actually going to be able to include in the model starts to drastically fall off. So I decided and looked at a lot of the data and came up with the best parameters for my model, and that was to make sure that each user has played a minimum of five games and that there's a minimum of three users per game before including them in the model, and I got pretty good results. In addition to the results you see on the screen, there's also a 3x increase in error for the random model over the model that I chose in the end. We can also look at qualitative results for this model, but it's kind of tricky because we're not just looking at similar items or people who are similar, right? We're looking at both at the same time. So, for example, we have a user who liked these four games by playing them a lot compared to other users, and someone who at the same time didn't play these games as much as other users. And the results we get from this user for our recommender system are actually pretty interesting. Given some background I have in playing video games, I can tell you that these recommendations are actually pretty reasonably good. This person seems to maybe like multiplayer games, shooters that are not too serious or dark. But ultimately, in the end, with a recommender, these offline metrics are not going to be as good as evaluating them online. So what we want to do is put this into practice and see how our offline metrics correlate with the actual user evaluation. There's a lot of additional steps we can do with our system, and I'm not going to get into those, but there's a lot of ways to improve it as well. Okay, so that's the recommender system that I built. If you have any more questions about that, please feel free to contact me on LinkedIn or to look at the repo on GitHub. Thank you.